I'm Marlon Bornett. I study transportation planning. I'm in the Department of Planning, Policy and Design in the School of Social Ecology. In a lot of ways, my research looks at the question, if we built cities differently, would people travel differently? In particular, would they drive less? One way that this matters is the link to greenhouse gas emissions. Almost a third of all greenhouse gas emissions in the United States are from the transportation sector. And so naturally, the question of possibly reducing driving and using the built environment as a tool to reduce driving has been drawn into the climate change greenhouse gas emission debate. In the metropolitan Los Angeles region, there are 189 cities and 5 counties in a place that has 19 million persons. And the plans and the government actions of these 194 municipal governments affect what gets built on the grounds. The transportation landscape is changing, and with it, our urban development landscape is changing. How do we go into cities that were built for one kind of transportation system, the automobile, and retrofit them to allow multiple kinds of transportation systems? My research has been funded by several entities. Most important has been the University of California Transportation Center. Their support has been fundamental. They've supported a lot of this research that I did going back 8 to 10 years ago, looking at the impact of the California Safe Routes to School construction program. We found that those students who would pass those improvements from a relatively inexpensive program, putting in a sidewalk, putting in a stoplight, had an increase in walking that was 3 times what we saw in a control group. At the same time, we also participated with the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation to try to really refine our methods for measuring the built environment. We developed something called the Irvine, Minnesota Inventory. It's a formalized way to scientifically measure built environment elements that might be linked to walking, and that inventory is now being used by several researchers across the country and even across the world. Most recently, the California Air Resources Board has provided funding to me and to colleagues. We've collaborated building a set of 15 policy briefs. These are intended to inform local governments as they develop their plans that the Air Resources Board requires to achieve particular greenhouse gas emissions targets. So that's where my research comes in. How would you measure how much greenhouse gas emission reduction you could actually get out of particular land use policies? We've moved from just saying, is there an association, is it causal, to saying we could actually measure. With several of my colleagues here in the School of Social Ecology, we've organized a Metropolitan Futures Initiative that is dedicated to taking scientific information and working in partnership with government officials and planners across the broad metropolitan area to address how we can answer questions of planning and governance that lead to higher quality of life, economic vitality, and environmental sustainability. Thank you.